This case study is regarding multiple Yahoo data breaches across 4 years. Records exposed, 3 billion. Type of attack, unauthorized access. So what happened exactly? What happened? According to the website for the Yahoo data breach settlement, the company's cybersecurity issues contained in this matter extended from 2012 to 2016. But the information gets more specific and says data breaches involving stolen information occurred from 2013 and 2016. While so-called data security intrusions, where an infiltration happened without those responsible taking data, happened from at least January-April 2012. Then, cyber criminals did not take the same kind of data in every case or behave the same way. For example, in 2012, two separate hackers broke into Yahoo's online infrastructure without taking anything. The next year, cyber criminals behaved maliciously when they took records from all of Yahoo's accounts, which totaled about 3 billion. In that instance, the information seized by the hackers could have allowed them to access things like users' email accounts and calendars. In 2014, hackers directly targeted Yahoo's user database, affecting about 500 million people. The cyber criminals reportedly got account details such as people's names, email addresses, passwords, phone numbers, and birthdays. The aftermath of that event continued for years later, sparking increased public awareness both about these breaches and the respective cybersecurity laws and regulations. It was not until 2018 that news broke about Yahoo's shell company receiving a $35 million fine for failing to disclose the 2014 incident. The final cybersecurity matter addressed by the settlement happened from 2015 to September 2016. In that instance, hackers used cookies to break into the accounts of about 32 million individuals. So, how did Yahoo respond? Unfortunately, Yahoo failed to issue the kind of sweeping statement you might expect to give the public reassurance that the company has recommitted itself to cybersecurity in meaningful ways. Instead, the brand has a section on its website devoted to security notices. There, you can find the data breach notices that Yahoo sent to its users in September 2016, December 2016, and October 2017. Here's a breakdown of what Yahoo pledged to do to stop future incidents in each case: invalidated unencrypted security questions and answers, continually enhancing the systems that detect and prevent unauthorized access, required all affected and unaffected users to change their passwords. Yahoo's statements mentioned the company was working with law enforcement officials, but the documents did not give concrete details about the status of the investigations. The company did briefly reveal that a state-sponsored party may have been behind the 2014 issue. What should you know about the settlement? In April 2019, Yahoo agreed to a $117.5 million settlement associated with the above incidents, which affected about 3 billion people. It covers approximately 896 million accounts belonging to as many as 194 million people in the US and Israel. Verizon Communications Incorporated, of which Yahoo is now a part, also promised to spend $306 million between 2019 and 2022 to improve Yahoo's cybersecurity, which is 5 times more than what Yahoo itself spent between 2013 and 2016. Verizon also indicated it would quadruple Yahoo's IT staff. What should the information security team learn from this breach? The Yahoo data breach was, in part, as bad as it was because of poor security practices. Hackers gained access to Yahoo's network through the use of a phishing scheme. All it took was one employee with network access clicking on a malicious link for a hacker to get through. Once in, the hackers were able to guarantee their continued access to the network. Also, some confidential data, including security questions and answers, was stored unencrypted by Yahoo. Information security teams should prepare for attacks that use social engineering just as much as brute force attacks. This will require CISOs to provide some level of cybersecurity education to non-cybersecurity and non-tech-savvy staff. CISOs should also ensure that basic security measures, like the encryption of identifying information, are in place. Breaches are increasingly prevalent threats. The frequent news of breaches is enough to make people think that they're at risk by using the internet in any way. Although it took a while for sufficient corrective action to happen in Yahoo's case, that's hopefully changing now. This is a gigantic cybersecurity failure. A hack of this magnitude is a strong reminder that the company has work to do regarding improving its cybersecurity. Cybersecurity breach is like a grave tragedy, which, we mistakenly think, it happens to somebody else, before it strikes us. As a minimum, the organization and information security professionals need to have very comprehensive information security compliance checklist to ensure longevity of business and careers. To obtain Infosec audit checklist, please visit online store of ISO Training Institute website mentioned in the description below.